winning.
Poison gear! Xbox.
We have taken objective Edward. We have taken objective Duff.
Thank you. because IGN was open and shit. God, you fucking hard hurt, dude.
I'm watching this thing on YouTube where these guys are all pro Xbox, and they talked all this shit that all these games like Forza and Horizon's a multi-billion dollar company. I said, if it's a multi-billion dollar company, and I wish I could talk to these guys. I said, if Microsoft was a multi-billion dollar company on these games that you're talking about, they wouldn't have to worry about putting out another system. These guys are so fucking butthurt. And I love all consoles, all thing, which way, but I'm more PC than anything when it comes down to it.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm looking at how they talked about, like how these guys do not, these Xbox guys do not like IGN. And I don't like IGN for the fact that they pump a lot of shit that is falsely advertised just to make money. And these Xbox guys, they're pissed about that, because the fact that it is, they have pumped so much shit that's false, this and that. All these streamers are pumping certain games, Xbox games are not really getting pumped anymore. It's because the Xbox sucks. That's all to it, that's all I used to say. Them fuckers suck.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember back in the day, people didn't believe me in this, that Xbox was going to crash. I saw the shit years ago. Now they're talking about, oh, Microsoft had this well, the thing that Microsoft fucked up and everybody don't admit, all these fan fucks don't admit, where they fucked up is talking about their R&D, talking about they didn't want to do this, you weren't going to get that. You gave PlayStation breathing room on shit like that to fuck you up, and then fuck you up in the media, and then don't say that Microsoft didn't try to fuck whatchamacallit up in the media. They were all both fighting one another back in the day when PlayStation had it big. Xbox didn't have none of the market. They didn't have nothing when they came out in the early 90s. You couldn't sell an Xbox. Xbox didn't get big until 3 years down the road, until PlayStation fucked themselves. A lot of the people don't want to admit that, but they want to be all these fan fucks. Don't look at their previous histories. Yes, you got all these titles that people don't want to play no more. No, you got a bunch of titles like Forza and Horizon that come out every year. People get tired of games that come out every fucking year. You know? That's why you don't see Gran Turismo coming out every fucking year. You see it every 5 years. You know, but these guys are getting on these lines and start bitching about this, bitching about that. Don't even know what the fuck you're talking about. You guys are the ones. Microsoft was the one that started blasting these games out. And then don't want to did all these fraudulent business shit with other people. People didn't want to be with them for 10 years. They were milking people. That's why you saw all those big major companies abandon ship. And then IGN abandoned ship and went, was on PlayStation's dick. Now, when that Scorpio comes out, we're going to really see how many PlayStation people are going to be around. To me, I can care less. If you have exclusive shit that I want to play, you know, just like the same with Gears of War. Gears of War was utterly a failure on the Xbox One. It looked like shit. Played good to some extent.
We have taken objective,
but you did all these microtransactions and all this other bullshit. You know, Microsoft has got to get their money. And that small company is really hasn't made any full money to keep making another Gears of War. They think you might make another Gears of War, but Microsoft is going to be the one to push them to make another Gears of War. That's why they knew that system. They knew that Microsoft shit was going down the tunnel. And all these dick-riding fucking Xbox fan fucks don't know their company went down to shit. Because the real truth came out, especially all that broken shit they had for years. Nobody wanted to deal with that shit. People forget about shit. People forget so much shit where Microsoft gave breathing room to PlayStation. PlayStation wasn't like what it was. Now, but
oh,
they
no.
But they came on here, they talked about PlayStation Now, that PlayStation Now spent 250 fucking million on, which I like, PlayStation, why the fuck did you make that dumbass move? And then you got rid of it because you want people to buy your system instead of streaming it. That's the reason why they got rid of it. And then they, another reason why they got rid of it, truly what they really got rid of it is Xbox people were playing it on PC. And they said, well, fuck it, we got to get rid of this shit, we're losing money. We're not making any money, we're losing money now. Because that really was the market, what they were trying to do, like these guys said it, is, you know, for the people that were still playing PlayStation 3, why PlayStation 3 could have that venue for those people to still play PlayStation 4 games without having a PlayStation 4. And I've always thought that was stupid. I said, if you're in to make money, why would you put out that app? Why would you put that streaming service out? I would put that out just only exclusive shit, like TVs and shit like that. But they got rid of it all. And it's a smart decision. They finally got rid of it and woke up and say, well, shit, this is a lot of money, a lot of resources that we're spending dumbly on. I think we might as well need to cut this out. I couldn't tell you that before you even did it. Wasn't a smart move, because if you're pushing PS Pro instead of all this other bullshit, you know, I fault PlayStation on that. I fault them with their VR shit. Is you should have waited. You had a very high power for machine to do that. See what Xbox puts out this coming fall, which that Scorpio will come out this fall. There's no doubt about it. They have no choice. But these suck fucks come and play. Oh, Xbox is number one. No, the fuck they're not. They're number three. To Nintendo, of all people. But we sold $1 billion. If you sold $1 billion, why are you putting out another console? The fucking unpowered-ass console. I own both of them. I could tell you, I wouldn't even recommend nobody to spend no money on that bitch. How low underpowered of it is. Battlefield was a true test of that. When you don't got HDR support on your shit, PlayStation doesn't got HDR support on Battlefield, and Battlefield looks pretty as fuck. Mm. And it's jagged in some places when you put the HDR support on, because I'm fucking it with it now just to look at it. It looks jagged as shit on the edges. You know, but they want to talk that shit. You know, Xbox people, you had it good for a long period of time. You had the market. But you went back and gave the market to the fucking PlayStation. Like a dumbass. But these guys that come on YouTube talking all this hateful bashing and shit, talk about your shit. Talk about what reality go on. I can go back and talk about Xbox on the behalf of saying that they didn't put out a smart system. They try to fool people with that fucking television shit. And then when they talked about you couldn't share games and do that shit, you just put yourself in a fucking hole. People didn't want to hear that shit. People didn't want to hear you know, personal business talk and trying to monopolize shit. People did not want to hear that shit.
We have an airship en route.
People did not want to hear that shit. People wanted to hear, what games did you have? And them fuckers didn't have any games. Like right now, they're suffering with games. But they talk about Forza made so much, $1.3 million. $1.3 million to me, I think that's a failure on a game. Because that's the budget of the fucking game itself, is $1 million. But they're in here just like Xbox people did, always do. They protest what they made. They haven't made shit on that system. They're just wasting their revenue, what they've been at for years. They're wasting the money that they have had on the PS3 on 360 days just to try to keep up with the PlayStation. Now, and the PlayStation doesn't have a remarkable. See, this is what's funny about the whole shit about it. PlayStation's got dog-ass service, and Xbox has got the best service, but they can't have any reliable games on their shit. But they talk all this shit. Why is Xbox, if you sold that much, why is nobody streaming your shit? Nobody's streaming Xbox shit. A lot of people are streaming PS4 shit and PC shit. You don't see no Xbox shit really getting streamed heavily. Like it used to back in the day. Motherfuckers talk all that shit. I love how these fan fucks, Xbox fan fucks, come on and talk all this blasted shit. I heard an hour of the shit and I laughed. I said, if you guys were, or 38 minutes of it, or 23 minutes of it, we have lost objective Charlie. If they were selling shit, you guys would be number one.
You know, yeah, if they were.
Yeah, and you won't hear Spencer talking about we need to get back in the running of things. We fucked our fan base. I could have told you that 4 years ago, right when you announced that shit. That is like the worst thing you could ever do. And then I've been waiting for a title for the Xbox to be in love with it. You know, they've been rendering the same shit. And that's the thing that hurt them too, is you render the same shit. You got Halo 2. What was that? MMO game. It looks like dog ass. It looks just like shit. I wouldn't want to play that. It's choppy. It don't look good. It just doesn't look good. Your last Halo didn't do good at all. But you talked all this shit because you got this. Oh, I feel bad for them. Because at the end of the day, they don't have shit. No, that's a good warning sign is when you got to put out another system to match the PS4. And the PS4 is not a massive system. They did the bare minimum. If you look at the shit in the PlayStation, it's the bare minimum. Now they got to come out and put out this horse-powered fucking system to try to outdo the PlayStation. And that's crazy. And then you made your fan base of PlayStation just go utterly stupid. Your fan base is just stupid as fuck. They don't know what they're talking about. Now, if they put up that massive machine, which I've always said, if they would have did that shit beforehand and not try to fuck people, they fuck people. That's why they're in that predicament that they are in. People got tired of this shit and moved to PlayStation. To get more shit. You know? People got tired of broken fucking product that wasn't moving right. People got tired of fucking broken ass systems of the 360. Bitch didn't last 6 months, and then yet your engineers talked about the shit. The gossip under gossip. You know, people want to talk that shit. Xbox doomed themselves. The users just got smart and say, well, fuck this shit. We're not going to deal with this shit. It wasn't the fact that PlayStation was giving free shit away. Now, like the dumbass niggas like you, I'm going to buy the game because it's free. No, because the fact of it is, the reason why I got on board is they made an actual real good game I enjoy. I just got tired of that bullshit. I was getting fucked in the ass. I got tired of that shit. That's the same way with consoles here with PlayStation. Oh, I'm getting tired of getting fucked in my ass. You can't get your shit right. Fuck did he say? You know, it's the same way, you know, I said for a lot of shit. And people don't understand that. It's like, Nori, why you say that? Well, I'm getting tired of PlayStation in general with their, you know, not updating their shit correctly. You're just putting shit out just to try to beat the Xbox. Put out some quality shit. Well, you don't have to do all that stupid shit. No, but it's just so funny when I look at shit like that. And I say, oh, Xbox as a whole. And then you got some Xbox people hanging on for dear life. You know, them motherfuckers talk that crazy shit too. Just hanging on for dear life. And I have the system. I don't think the system's that great. It's cluttered. We have lost a lot of clutter on their dashboard. They still ain't got out. The only thing about the Xbox that's good is their servers is good. Good servers, but no games.
Mm-hmm.
Until they get the games and get shit right, I'll fuck with them. We have taken objective Charlie. The only thing that's good on their shit is a controller. Controlling the servers. You know, but they made a lot of faulty machines. You know, a lot of the Xbox people won't admit they made a lot of faulty shit. Just like the PlayStation did back in the day. When they learned from their mistake, you didn't see hear them go, oh, we sell this, we sell that. PlayStation was kind of modest.
They learned from that shit.
Yeah, they were modest about their shit. Now, when, you know, the reason why people talk bad about Xbox is, Xbox came out and talked all this shit. We're going to be number one at this. We're going to take this away. No, people didn't want to hear that shit. Because at the end of the day, when you failed, and then you didn't put your R&D in there right, people didn't want to hear that shit. People did not want to hear that bullshit. Well, you were taken away from people. PlayStation.
Yeah, I'll go over to that.
We have lost objective Charlie.
I didn't know where he was at.
We have lost objective Duff.
I had an altercation and shit in Walmart and shit with Crystal the other night. Some niggas was in there. It's like, I don't even know what the fuck what was going on. But these niggas was like, we was walking by, right? You know, to the average nigga around here, she a dime. You know what I mean? Because she ain't from here. They don't know her. You know what I mean? So she's like fresh, you know, and new. So every nigga's thirsty. So I'm walking with her through Walmart. She's like, got her arm through my arm. We walking, going to get new bed sheets for the bed. Some nigga stops me that's working at for DirecTV, and he's like, so what kind of cable provider do you got? I was like, I don't got one. I got PlayStation. That's all I need. You know what I'm saying? Right. He's like, well, look, man, do this and do that. I'll give you a $250 gift card in the mail. I'm like, oh, bet. I was like, what I was going to do is just get the service and cancel the shit after I get the gift card. You know what I mean? I don't need the shit. So I'm just going to cancel it for 1 month. So it's no contract, so that's another good thing about it. But I got the service for like $30 a month. Dude kept fucking talking to me, and then he kept like fucking talking to her, like asking her where she was from and asking her if she wanted to, because I had to give up my information. He kept trying to get her to give up her information to put it on the table. And she's like, I don't even own my own house. She's like, he's like, oh, that don't matter. He's like, you can have it in your room, blah, blah. She's like, no, you know, no. And I thought he was doing too much to me. I thought it was on the borderline of disrespect. You know what I mean? And then he hands me the phone. I'm on the phone with fucking DirecTV. They're telling me, asking me, confirming if this is okay and all this. This nigga sitting there talking about where you exactly from. This and that. Oh, you see, okay. My roommate, he got waves and all this crazy shit. So he started going ham on it, right? I'm like, this nigga really ain't trying to holler at everyone. I'm standing right here. Right, wow. So I snaps out, right? So I didn't really snap out right there. I handed him back the phone. I was like, look, cuz, here's your phone. I'm done with this shit. So I walked away because they was like holding me up because I was doing laundry. And they was like, if you just give me 3 more minutes, I'll give you a gift card for $250, and I will make sure I guarantee that you get the gift card. He's like, you can. He's like, with that money, you can go and buy as much clothes as you want and laundry detergent. I was like, all right. So after a while, I got tired of the bullshit.
You just gotta be careful, though. Gotta be careful with that, cause they could lock you into some bullshit.
I know. So I walked away. I'm asking him when I get halfway down the aisle. I'm like, wait a minute. I'm trying to remember what dude was saying when I was on the phone with the lady. I'm like, what'd that nigga say to you? And he was like, she was like, I can't remember everything he was saying. I was like, look, hold up. I just want to know if I was disrespected just now. You know what I mean? I need to know what he just said to you. That's fucked up. You know, you don't do shit like that when you're professional working. You know what I mean? Especially what now with me standing right there, like, I don't like this soft type of nigga and shit. I would bust a nigga's melon quick. So I was gonna go back there and bust his melon, right? She stopped me. She's like, no, we're at Walmart. I'm like, all right, cool. I understood that. I left. I was right. Like, yo. Then we got kind of like in a sideline argument with it all night and shit. She kept talking about it. I'm like, look, man, just drop the shit. You know, and she's like, you know what? I'll just go home. I was like, look, I'm not gonna give you a pity party. If you wanna go home, you have a car. You can go home. You know, I'm not holding you here against your will. Go ahead.
Yeah, but see, you gotta.
I'm not gonna. No. You're not gonna kiss. You don't kiss bitches' asses by being like, no, baby, please stay. Come on. No, that's a weak nigga shit. That's some weak ass shit.
Right, but you gotta.
I'm not gonna sit there and kiss her ass. I'm gonna let her go. Now she's texting me today, talking about she's sorry. You know, she's the one that blew up. I didn't blow up. I kept my cool. I think I'm in the right here because I think that was kind of ignorant what that dude was doing and shit. And she could have handled it a little better by saying, you know, I would not feel comfortable giving out my information. You know, this has something to do with him. I'm not involved in this. That's what she should have said, you know, instead of saying,
right,
you know, humoring the guy.
But
don't give up your personal information to some fucking stranger.
What I'm saying is that's the type of woman you got. See, I don't know why you get upset about these women that you fuck with. You know they don't got the fucking... That right there tells you, right there, she do not have the capability.
It wasn't even about her. It was
listen what I'm saying, Soul. You're not catching the point. You're missing my theory on this. If I would have caught onto that and I saw that incident going on, I said, damn, this bitch ain't no good. Right there is like, in my mind would click. It's like, do I want to keep steady fucking with this? Because I know myself with bitches... I'm going to take this little point and drive it through the wall. And then you're driving it through the wall. Right there, I would have been like, all right, fine. You go home. Leave it at that. Don't have shit to do with me. Because if you can't act like a woman and cut the shit off, that just cut it off. Because what she did, she just kept, as a woman, she just prolonged the shit to see what she was going to get a reaction out of you. You get these women.
The guy was prolonging it because I was trying to get the fuck out of there because I had to get, you know, back
right.
to the laundromat.
But she
he
didn't,
just kept like fucking
Crystal
trying
didn't,
to,
Crystal
you know.
Didn't help you. She went and did like what a typical woman do, prolong the situation. Right there, Soul should automatically tell you what type of woman that you got. Now, if it's
going
to be
your... She wasn't going all out like... giving him her phone number and her street address. She just said she said she was from Ohio. She didn't go into town detail or any
right,
kind of detail
the,
like that. But still, the fact that she even said that kind of pissed me off. You know, I'm like, damn, you don't even know this cat. And he's like, well, but he did tell us where he was from. He was like, I'm from Pensacola, Florida, blah, blah, blah. But it only
right.
pissed me off when he started talking about the waves and shit and now all that crazy shit about his roommate because it was two of them there. And I'm like, the other dude's trying to distract me while the other guy's over there trying to spit game. You know, and she modest. She was being modest. She didn't give up no number or nothing like that. Now, she would have gave him the number and gave him specific details
where she lived,
and then put her name on the fucking paper, then,
now,
yeah,
see,
that would have
been. This is what I'm
going to
say that where you're not too smart about. If you saw that shit going on, that's not a good woman to hang. That's a woman that you want to fuck and leave alone, you know? Not make no relationship, none of that shit, because you're going to have that same fucking problem down the road. That's a warning sign, Soul. Just take heed. That is a fucking warning sign that you're going to deal with. You know, but you don't think shit like that, like I do. My bitch seen him. If the bitch is with me, she knows her place,
what
to say.
What is up with Battlefield?
She knows where her place, she'll know her place. She know what she can do. But if you get out of line to start spitting game and, I mean, I understand being friendly, but that causes a fight. That causes a scene. And then she came home and started steady talking about the shit. I was like, saying, bitch, no. Go.
Because I wasn't saying, like, only reason why she was talking about it is because I was real quiet in the car. I really didn't have much to say. I just wanted to go back and do laundry. She's like, what, you're mad at me or something? Because this dude was fucking... She's like, I get hit on a lot. Which is true. I know a lot of women
do. So, who gives a fuck? That's the type of woman you don't want to deal with. If she knows she comes out the gate... No, she come out the gate saying, I get hit on a lot. That's the type of... That's an insecure bitch right there. Right on off the bat. That's an insecure thing that she's going to use that shit against you. You know, like I say, she's just good for a fuck and get the fuck out of there. Don't keep having her around doing all that shit. If you've already had one incident, which guarantee you keep fucking with this bitch, you're going to have another incident. Mark my words. For some, with all these women that you get, their mind's not right. You can get them, but dealing with them, that's on your account. And I guarantee you, this is not going to be the last of it. You're going to hear some more shit of it.
Yep. What is wrong with Battlefield?
I don't know. It was fucked up earlier. I couldn't get on either.
Oh shit! It's on. Hell yeah! Finally.
No, she's gonna use that tactic. She knows that. You know, you didn't want to go down that road of feeling like you were soft. That's why you exploded. And I know you did. I know how you exploded.
I disrespected. I felt that I was disrespected. Well, I didn't explode on those dudes because I didn't really understand what he was trying to do until I was thinking about it when I was walking away. And then I was sitting there thinking, like, what the fuck did he just say? You know what I mean? And then I can't remember everything he said, blah, blah, blah. And that's what got me kind of pissed when she couldn't remember exactly what the motherfucker... Well, I mean, it didn't have to be exact, but I couldn't remember what he was saying. I couldn't hear it clearly what he was saying when I was on the phone.
But the thing he was doing is...
And I thought he was crossing lines.
He was hitting on her. Then trying to sell a product at the same time. That's what those salesmen do. Mm-hmm. You sit there all day.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody's stupid. But then again, but the thing that Crystal did wrong is she kept fucking with the dude. Just because she's pretty. See, now you don't see the inside shit that I see. You just say, well, okay.
I do see it. That's the reason why she ain't sitting here.
Yeah, she did that just to taunt with your ass. You know? Right, you keep fucking with her, that's what you're gonna deal with, and that's what you gotta put in your back of your mind. That's what you gotta fucking deal with.
I'm gonna see how she acts when I go to this concert, because I already got the damn ticket. Can't take it back. Ain't nobody else I know to take. It's too late now.
Go yourself and have a good time. Fuck her. You already got what you want out of her.
Then that ticket goes to waste. I ain't got to pay for nothing after that. The limo's already paid for. The ticket, I didn't pay for that. My cousin paid for it because he's going with Bone and all them.
No, what I meant is...
I know what you mean. Go by myself.
Go by yourself. Chill.
That's what I mean.
Chill the fuck out. You don't need her all the time around.
It ain't got to be with her. It could be with anybody. But what I'm saying is that we're all taking dates to the concert. We're not taking niggas. You know, ain't no niggas going. I mean, if there's niggas going, they're not going to be with us.
Right. But I'm just saying in general...
I really don't have anybody that, you know, short notice like that.
Right.
Anybody I think that would be worth a damn anyway.
You gonna do
it? Is
that
a tank up there?
That's just like I say, you like to deal with a lot of shit. I don't like to deal with shit like that. If I had a woman that I was fucking around and not even dating yet and she did that shit? No. You gonna still say the fuck?
We just started dating, actually. Well, that's another thing he asked me. He asked me if he asked me if we were, you know, dating or whatever. And I was like, we just started dating, just started talking, trying it out. Because he was trying to see if we lived in the same house. That's I think that's what he was trying to do. And
yeah,
I was like, no,
doing,
we don't live in the same house.
But doing that and hitting at the same time?
Yeah. That's what was getting me pissed about the dude. I was like, you know, at first it was cool. Then he's like, kept trying to drag her into the conversation. Like, she ain't got no fucking control over shit here. The fuck you talking about? Nigga, this me. Ain't nothing. And even if she did live here, my name would still be primary on the lease. Ain't no bitch throwing me out of nowhere. Cops come, guess who's leaving? Not me.
Like I said, you like to deal with shit like that.
I'll just keep her
as a fuck buddy. I wouldn't make no fucking hard relationship. Trying to make a hard relationship with a person that you don't even fucking know. And that right there is a... That's like having a...
Well, when I say talking, I mean, like, you know, that's what... the whole talking process is. Like, you get to know that person during that.
But she fucked up on that one.
We're not, like, that's not my girlfriend, but we're just talking, you know?
She fucked up on that point, because the fact of it is, that just, like, for me, I'm on the smart type. It just makes an eyebrow riser. I mean, make my eyebrow rise.
Yeah, my eyebrow did raise a little. It did, but it did. I mean, it wasn't to the point to where it was like, oh, fuck this whore. You know what I mean? No, she didn't go that far. But it was to the point to where I was like, damn, you could have handled that just a little bit better. But the way they ambushed us was kind of fucked up, because we were having a good conversation talking about, she's talking about what she was going to wear to the concert. I was talking about what I was thinking about getting, and if I was going to get anything.
Yeah, but see, like I said, you put a lot of high hopes for shit that is not right.
Fuck. How did he know I was right there by that wall?
But it is what it is, so that's what you like. Like I said, you like that controversy. If a person didn't like controversy, I wouldn't deal with that shit. Right there,
it's hard to escape it whenever it just happens. It's not your fault.
That's the number one thing I couldn't deal with. Well, I would say, what? Wait a minute? It said, excuse me, are you going to just sell me the product, or are you trying to fucking talk to her and sell me the product? No, it only be one thing or the other. You know, I would be like, right there, would have been seized.
He only really started going in on her whenever I was on the phone with what's her name, because I was distracted almost. He thought I was distracted, but I wasn't. I was listening to him. And then I wasn't even listening to the lady pretty much half the time. I was listening to what he was saying, to trying to figure out what the fuck he was trying to do. And she was just standing there. She wasn't really saying nothing.
We have taken fuck all that.
But only thing she did say is that she said that, you know, she don't own her house, and, you know, that she cannot make any decisions on any kind of service or anything like that. And that, because that was like his final close on trying to get her number, and she shut that down with that, and that was cool. But just the whole thing, like, if she did, I told her when we was in the car, because she was like, you know, upset because I wasn't talking. I was like, look, if you just would have said, look, you know, this has to do with him, I'm not involved in it. You start talking, no, I'm not involved in the house. You know, leave me the fuck alone. Not leave me the fuck alone, but, you know. Then I would, if I was her, I wouldn't have said another word. I'd have just been like, you know, fuck all that, you know. These niggas on some other shit.
Yeah, but she should have saw that coming.
The one dude.
But see, the thing that it would piss me off is what.
I didn't see it coming.
The thing that really pissed.
I was surprised.
The thing that pissed me off is what you said is that, oh, I get hit a lot all the time. Okay, bitch, you're a drama queen.
She said I get hit on a lot all the time.
She's a drama queen.
One thing, pretty girls, man.
One
these
thing,
guys,
and she's not to me. She's not all that pretty. Them big ass bags up on her eyes. She's not that pretty to me.
I mean, that's just to you. You know, everybody has their own taste.
Yeah, she looked like she's been run down. That's what it is. A pretty bitch to me is like tattooed, look damn near like a model. That's beautiful shit, and they've got a good attitude. Not where.
Yeah, I don't want no bitch like that.
Oh,
that's
like
a fake bitch. She'll be worse than this one. If she looked like that, she'd be way worse.
Yeah, but see, she'll have more
confidence.
Those
bitches got egos like crazy.
Good man, I'm.
I try to stay away from them pretty ass bitches, man.
Yeah, but you get
they
the
got
one.
The worst
you,
egos.
You got the ones
I mean,
that.
They're very rare
got,
to find
one.
A humble one. Very
but
rare.
But see, and it's funny though, because the ones that you get are not credibility. They don't know how to act in public. They smother the fuck out of you, for one. It's like, I
but
can't...
But how do you
I
know couldn't. That unless you have to be around them in order to find that out? That's
yeah, but
what I'm
you find, but I'm saying,
you know
find, but if you find that out in 2 days, if she's been over the house for about a week, all right? For one, I don't like to be smothered. You know, you can come over when you want to, but give me some space.
She's only here for like 2 days.
Yeah, but she was over there last
well, actually,
weekend,
no,
right?
It was a day. It was a day.
She was
last
there for the
weekend,
whole
weekend
for like 3 days, right? And then she was over there mm-hmm. yesterday. You want to say that's a week? You know, they just like give me some time. Shit.
All she does when she's here is just sleeps. She don't even fuck with me, which is cool. I don't need that.
You get the, like I said, you get the craziest.
Ooh,
just crazy.
Man, I blew his.
Oh shit! I'm just like.
Somebody put me the fuck out.
I couldn't deal with all that bullshit. We are losing objective. Ooh, gotcha. Destroyed you. Killed me, but I killed you. Now, that's one of my number one rules. Like, if a bitch is trying to make me jealous, ain't gonna work. I don't get jealous. I just cut the shit off. I cut the fuck out of it. Just like Debbie.
I don't think she
do.
Was trying to do that. I think that she was trying to get out of the conversation as was politely as she could, and she should have been more of a bitch, really.
No, what she should have did is just to be more. If you know you're that beautiful, I would just cut that off and say, well, that's a personal issue. But if you're talking to someone that you don't want to relate information like that, that's a particular woman that. That's a really typical woman that does that. That means if you do that and you give up information and you don't know how to handle that, and that's the thing that you come up and say, I get hit on a lot. No, if you know you get hit on, I think I would be more secure of what I say to people. Objective butter. Kind of keep the conversation very short at a short basis. Now, if you out with Soul, act like you with Soul in a way. You know, she didn't, because she gave up all the information and made the situation more worse when she said, well, I get hit on a lot. Well, change.
Oh, she said that when we were in the car. She didn't say that.
I know, time. But I'm just saying that's. Oh, but okay. the thing that I'm saying is. No. The thing what I meant is she has that mentality of saying that. If she went to the car to say that to you, she already fucked up because she doesn't have a strong background of saying, well, you know what I should have did? I'm out with my man, and we've only been seeing, and I've been over to his house about 4 days tops. I think I need to act a little bit more appropriate. She didn't act appropriate. She just act like, oh, I'm going to say whatever, and I just say this excuse, I get hit on. Why the fuck would you say some shit like that? You know? That's like the same thing if you had a woman, yeah. Like, she'll go on PLNL, she says, I want to have a good man. I don't know what I want to say. I said, you're on a fucking dating site. Put something on there that sounds related to you. Related to what you want in life. Not just, whoa, I'm going to put something on there. And that's the same shit that I see on there. How many 500 women that say the same shit on this dating site? That means all you bitches are broken if you say the exact same shit. That means you do not know how to have a relationship. You do not know how to start from the beginning to succeed what you want. You know, that's the shit that I want. I want an intelligent bitch to where she's a freak, but she's intelligent. She says, I'm out with my man. I ain't gonna do nothing stupid. I'm gonna be intelligent of what I say. Now, I'm gonna, you know, like if she said, well, you know, like if that guy said, oh, you're very pretty. Thank you very much. I'm on my merry way. But her cop out is like, oh, I get hit on a lot. That means you got an ego problem. No? And the pictures I
see.
I
think she's actually insecure. I don't think she has an ego at all. I think that she needs to be more secure because she said something to me the other night. She's like, I know I'm not as thick as you would like me to be, but I'm gonna get a little thicker, get my booty thicker and this and that.
Why would you? But why would you do all that?
That shit. I'm like, I think you're straight. I mean, there's a such thing as too much ass. You know what I mean? Like, I dated a girl that had the biggest fucking butt ever, and I liked it at first, but man, that ass would just swallow me. I couldn't handle it. I just was like, this is just gross. She was pretty as fuck in the face, but that ass was just a monster. It was just too big. Like, and I told her, I was like, you know what, I like you a lot, and I think that, you know, Shantae, I think that you are spectacular, but your butt is just too fucking big. Like, fucking her on her back was amazing. That was great. But doggy
but that doesn't make a relationship, though. That's
no, it doesn't make a relationship, but you at least gotta enjoy it. Like, you know what I mean? You don't want to be grossed out.
But you gotta have some other things that make a woman what she is, you know? You know, mine is tattoos. I like a girl with tattoos.
I love tattoos.
You know, and
that's
you gotta
one thing I liked about Crystal also. She has a lot of those.
You know, you got something like that, and you got a different thing. You know, that adds on to my
meaningful tattoos too, not just bullshit like fucking Corona bottles and stupid shit like that. No, I mean like meaningful tattoos. It's something that, you know, your kids, and like she has each paw has one of her kids' names in it. That's cool. You know, you don't put some bullshit on there like some you know, I don't even know what the fuck I'm using as an example, but some crazy shit.
Yeah, see, but see, my thing is different.
All my tattoos are meaningful, every last one.
You know, like for mine, like my theory is, I just don't like a lot of drama tricks. I don't want it.
I don't either, man.
I want the ass. It might seem to you
from a perspective of your perspective that I like that type of shit, but I really don't, Nori. I really just want quiet. I just like peace. Like right now, how quiet it is in my house and this whole neighborhood is. You go outside, you don't see one fucking person moving. I can sit on my porch and.
But the thing of it is, you don't have quality. You have quantity, but you have no quality.
It's barely any. There is some quality, but that quality is very rare, and most of it's already taken. So.
But so, like I said, you get like for one, you know, you're not really doing your homework because, like you say, she has kids, she's taking responsibility of another person. She don't really got time, and the time that she's trying to prolong and do, you know. They're all the women that you got are mind troubled. Just like the same when I go in pee now, I don't want to hear a bitch that got mind problems. You're never right if you have mind problems. That's like a nigga that's got mind problems. He's always in jail. He's always got an excuse. He can't keep a job for more than 2 years. Those are problem issues that you don't want to bring in relationships. And then if you like drama and you like all that bullshit, you know, you don't want all that. Because a woman's going to naturally bring you drama. And then you got to deal with that on top of that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's a lot to deal with, dude. You know, like the last one, she just so much problems.
I know.
Insecurity issues.
Well,
that's
the fuck alone.
An insecurity thing for a woman, that is bad, dude. That is the number one thing. If the
Her
bitch has got
brain is fucked up. That bitch is mental.
If you got insecurity issues like Debbie is old. You know, she's a senior.
She is old.
She's old.
Oh, no.
I mean, but I'm just saying, when you're old like no, but see, you didn't get the thing that I want to say. When you get old like that, you get set in your ways that you'll never change. That bitch was broken from the start. She was fucked up. And I was just in it for the pussy because she was broken. I saw this shit. I was in it for the pussy. That's why I didn't make it anything further. I didn't want to chill with her anymore. I just wanted to fuck. You know, all you were is just fucking coming over here to fuck on your lunch break. After you did that incident, when we had that altercation, boy, I pulled the brakes. I literally pulled the fucking brakes. She was like a broken 4K TV that I didn't want to pursue no more. You know, I mean, I did it in such a way that it was so fucking smooth, dude. The bitch had to think about it. She literally think about it. And every time she saw me in public, she was mad as fuck. Oh, this is my new boyfriend. I don't give a fuck. And then he was mad at me. It's like, what the fuck you mad at me? You fucking her now. Oh, he came up.
Yeah,
oh, you're a cute guy. And like, what the fuck are you going to say that bullshit? You got the bitch. Go on and live your life. Do what the fuck you got to do. Don't make me upset. I'm too busy trying to play pool. And then he was trying to play all this hard case. I remember it. Trying to play a hard ass. I said, you fouled at the shot because we were playing Valley Rolls. I said, you fouled at the shot. Oh, I'm going to pick it up and shoot anyway. I said, why are you doing this racist bullshit just to prove a point? You fucking her. You know, I even told the dude in their face. I said, I'm not going to fight over no old bitch. If that bitch got you that fucked up in the head that you want to fight? And you're just a little cracker ass white boy. I would put a fist in your chest. And I was skinny at the time. Said I would put a fucking hole in your chest still. You're fucking with the wrong nigga, dude. But they these bitches got these niggas fooled. They got like PlayStation and Xbox got niggas fooled. They on that fucking dumb shit. It's like, I ain't gonna fight over no bitch like that. I'm gonna move to the next bitch. Just like if I was like what you were doing. I'll keep on moving to the next bitch. I'll keep Chris on the side, but not make no hard relationship. Like, I gotta get hard dick and ready and start the fight? Why? We have taken objective charge. I'm not married to your ass. If I was married to your ass, you would know the rules. You would know how to act like a woman should act like. And that's the problem with women. They don't know how to fucking act when they're in public.
Nope.
I would have cut that shit the fuck off. I mean, why would I have to sit there and get mad? If you knew if I was in the car, that would have been my same reaction like what you did in the car. Didn't say a word. You know I'm mad. Mm-hmm. Don't ask me why the fuck I'm mad. You know why the fuck I'm mad. Don't play that dumb shit like, oh, you mad. Yeah, you know I'm mad because you said too much. You're running at the fucking mouth. No, nowadays bitches just run at the mouth and they always did that shit back then. It ain't nothing different. You're not fooling nobody. You know, that's the shit that I always tell you to watch out. And I say, so you gotta watch out shit for that. Niggas gonna put you in a line of being getting fired at. That bitch knew what she was doing. But her excuse is, I get hit on a lot. Fuck that. That's gonna make me second. See, I would have told her straight the fuck off. I'd say, you know something? That's gonna make me second guess you every time. That's bad to start a relationship that way. Or get to know someone. Because, of fact, that's what
Holy
I would say.
Holy shit, Dory. Oh my god. Oh my god. My bad, yo. This fucking truck jumped over me, right? And I threw the fucking lipid charge underneath the bottom of it. Mm. And it jumped over me and it didn't kill me. And then it got stuck on the wall, right? And it just like, it was like the ass was up in the air and then it slammed down. And it was like, boom, everybody in that bitch died.
Nice. But see, you know, like I say, so that's my excuse. You know, bitches can't put that dumb shit on me, dude. They fool other niggas with that shit just because they're beautiful. That's the beauty. You know, that's you being a fool to a woman right there. And then you got to get mad to prove your point? No. That's a bitch that loves to start shit. You know, you're starting off on the wrong foot. I just don't know what bitches do nowadays. That's why I don't deal with it. Like I say, the only thing I want fucking up and be drama in my life is the PlayStation and the internet. The rest of the other bullshit, I'm not fucking with it. I can care less about it. Bitches is always trying to give niggas a heartache. And then call you back, I'm sorry. Yeah, I wish you would. I wish you would do that shit to me. I don't want to talk to you for a couple days, but you think about that shit. I'm an old school. I'm an old school nigga, that's what I would do.
Mm-hmm. I told her, I was like, I need to think about this for a couple days.
I'll see you next Friday or something.
Mm-hmm.
But that's how I do it. That's how I do shit. No, I make them think.
I do it the same way. I'm from the old school too.
I'll make you think. I'm going to make you really think just because you said that thing of, oh, I'm beautiful. I said, things that are beautiful is babies and PlayStations and shit like that. They're beautiful.
Oh, yeah.
Now, when you're cute, like I say to women, when you're cute, that's when you know I like you. Other than that,
I don't give a bitch credit for nothing that God gave her.
No, I give them credit when credit is deserved.
Yeah,
you know, in the book,
things that they've done, but not for their beauty because God gave them that. They didn't get that. They didn't earn that shit.
Yeah, but it's the fact the fact the way you're doing it. It's like you be nice to them, but like what she did, but being nice to her is a whole different thing. What she did to you was not being nice. That was being ignorant. You know, seeing how much she can enjoy, and that's that natural shit that women have. They want to see how far they can push the envelope of what they got, and then they running you around like a trophy, like you think you're running them around like a trophy. But you don't see that. That's, you know, that's the thing that I said. So you got to look out for that shit. What she's talking about, like, oh, I'm beautiful. That's just shit I don't want to hear because the fact it is, that's that mental.
I never heard her say.
That's that mental
she never
shit.
Said that to me.
That's that mental shit, and that's that insecurity shit.
She gets hit on a lot, but that's just niggas that are thirsty as fuck. And there's a lot of them around here.
But why would you say that comment? It says, you know, you just could have said something different than that. Something that was most inspiring to you that'll help you in a relationship. That's like me saying to a bitch, I got a big dick, I'm gonna pound the fuck out of you. Bitch, don't want to hear that. You just fucked up the pussy there. You might as well just said, well, fuck it. No, you got.